We are the Inadequate Stalkers. And as people file in, we do need a volunteer to help us out with getting started. Do you have somebody volunteer? Yes. Could you please tell us, if you wouldn't mind, your name and your street address?
Rebecca.
I live on Harvard Avenue.
Harvard Avenue. Excellent. What street or what number?
1442.
Okay. How big is your dog?
Everybody can come. There's two of them.
Come
on. Okay, not this one.
What color is your front door?
I don't know.
It's glass.
We just
glass.
Went there.
Excellent. All right. Thank you very much.
That reminds me of the Harvard-Yale game a few years ago when I was hit by a car. The car struck me right in the leg here. I was thrown onto the windshield and I flew. So I experienced human flight.
Harvard reminds me of the time that I told someone I went to Harvard and I didn't. I was wearing a Harvard sweatshirt that someone had given to me, and I just kind of always accepted that people knew I didn't really go to Harvard.
Glass doors makes me think of when I was a little kid, and me and my buddy were throwing rocks, because that's the best thing to do when you're like this high, and one of them went through.
So I wake up in the hospital, and they put me in the MRI chamber, and they tell me not to move, but the problem is, I was broken on this side of my body, so I couldn't really move, but then I twitched. And the doctor yelled at me.
So my sister's old school Mustang, we managed to put one of the rocks directly through the front windshield.
And that's why I was at the airport one day wearing my Harvard sweatshirt. And someone came up to me and goes, oh, you went to Harvard? And I said, yeah, of course I did. And they said, what's your major? And I said, English. And they go, me too. And then I got a little bit nervous. So I'm like, yeah, it's a great school. And they're like, what professor did you have? And I started making up names.
So we proceeded to completely pawn it off and tell them that there was a bird that was carrying a rock. And the rock somehow managed to fall.
And then when they released me from the hospital, they gave me this brace, but they didn't tell me that I should be moving my leg. So then I had to have surgery on New Year's Eve because I had to have physical therapy before the surgery.
So I convinced this other person that there were all these extra professors in Harvard that they just never
heard. A really, really big bird, my sister was really adamant telling us, and at 5 years old, I could believe that any bird must be able to...
So that was the worst New Year's Eve I'll ever have. I had knee surgery, I had a pain pump in my knee,
I'm a little bit through it.
Hello, sir.
Hello!
Did you go to Harvard? It's my alma mater.
Yeah, of course I did. I love the beautiful buildings.
Harvard University, the beautiful buildings.
Yes, the beautiful buildings. And I love the desert heat.
Oh, yes, me too. The cactus in the fall.
The cactus.
You're ready to check in for the 10-year reunion at Harvard?
Harvard.
We like to pronounce it the proper way.
The proper way.
Okay.
Yes.
Less people
think. Were you in hasty pudding?
Man, kids.
You're ruining everything.
No. This is a beautiful stained glass window before those kids started throwing those dead birds.
You know, I didn't really like that stained glass window, but whatever.
You didn't like the stained glass window with our leader's face on it.
Oh, yeah?
Our dear leader. And you didn't like the stained glass window.
Yeah, Pope Benedict, not my thing.
You realize that you're a cardinal, right?
I'm
sort of.
Like, I like it. Like,
you dedicated your entire life to a religion. And you're sort of a cardinal?
It seemed like a good idea at the time. It's like,
so cardinal, I'm here to confess my sins. I don't know what I should do as penance. I lied, I cheated. Should I say some Hail Marys or what should I do?
Yeah, maybe give me a burger?
Okay. Hi, welcome to the Pearly Gates. You're just going to have to answer some cardinal questions. Should be easy.
I know all about God, church.
the diapers again.
The dog's in the diapers. Yeah. That was last week, the dog's in the diapers.
I said again.
Again, he did.
You know, Mary,
Mary.
They have to eat this artisanal, non-GMO, organic food. If I don't feed them that, they get the diaper treatment.
They get the diaper treatment.
Yes, yes.
And you...
Should I bring them into work?
Part of me doesn't believe you really have dogs.
Okay, okay. How could I...
Hark,
hark. Come on. Oh. Yeah. This is Phoebe. And this is Bud.
Part of me feels like you just went down to the kennel. Your dog understands English.
Harvard Yale game, something.
I just wasn't listening. I don't know. Sports should be women. I just assumed that you invited me here, so.
I wasn't really listening either. I was hoping you could tell me what was going on, because I don't get sports either. Women.
Maybe we should just, like, I don't know, show up and someone will guide us.
Like, do you know what
I
mean?
Yeah. I don't know, maybe.
Hey.
Just follow
cut to womanly things.
All right, we gotta go rack these balls.
I have the scalpels, but
you forgot the patient.
To be honest, I don't really understand this patient thing. I mean, supposed to cut them.
Yeah, fixed them.
Did you see my Harvard medical school degree?
If I remember correctly, it's pronounced Harvard.
If you're simple. So these scalpels, I'm so used to the nurses doing something with them, and I just stand and observe.
Well, yeah, but I'm kind of new. I sort of assumed you would.
You're new too!
Oh my gosh, I'm new.
So
all right, where's this patient? I got 10 minutes before I can leave for Cairo.
Patient has a fractured tibia. She got hit by a car.
It's at the Harvard Yale game.
At the Harvard, it was a great game.
Oh, that was excellently. Sorry. That was an excellent game.
I don't really understand the rules.
Yeah, what did you think? I'm women. I don't know.
Art class. I don't know if I'm feeling this so much.
You gotta be
guys, one.
were you just looking for this piece of gold? I don't know, you seemed hovering around it.
No, no, we're not.
How did you come up here front?
We're reporting live here today from the Harvard-Yale game. Apparently some woman has been hit by a car. We're going to go straight to our reporter on the scene. Buster, do you have anything for us?
Yeah, Jim, thanks. it seems that she was just completely run up. Yes, she's lying in front of me, Jim.
Buster, that's a great shot. Stay there.
Yeah. Let me see if I can get an interview. Ma'am, how are you feeling right now?
Don't worry, I'm the doctor.
It hurts, and she wants somebody to dial 911. Yes. Oh, there is somebody here that can dial 911. Ma'am, do you think you're going to survive?
Did you go to are you a doctor? No, I'm not.
No, I went to Haver.
You I'm a doctor.
Buster, ask her what she thinks of today's game results.
What do you think of today's game results?
What was the score again?
5-37. Maybe.
Good job. I can die in peace.
Good. She's happy, sir. Back to you, Jim. Thank you very much.
Thank you for your reporting. This is the kind of hard-hitting news we have here at Channel 6.
Okay. So, I heard you change your name to include fries. That was our thing. We were the potato sorority.
Saw the potato light. What can I say? Fries before guys.
Saying that.
It's my new life motto.
You know what we say over here at Yale.
Pie before guys.
Yeah, where are your potatoes?
Yeah. Potatoes. Come on, potatoes. Come on. I got my food. Give me over a pie. Any pie?
Shit, ma'am. Hold up.
We're gonna have to let you go.
Yeah, so what am I?
am I like the sacrificial lamb of like Harvard?
Harvard?
She's Lindsay is Harvard, I think. Or are we Yale?
Just a bit, just a wee. Just some waterboarding. You're gonna be okay.
Tickle.
Yeah, just tickle and waterboarding.